Today's topic is about terry towels. As you can see, the surface of terry towels is very hard to detect, and therefore weft detection is not possible. However, they require also a very good quality, and we have to make sure that the distortion has to be eliminated and the length repeat is also always the same. And therefore, we have to use a special technology. I want to show you this technology right now. Let's jump right in. Hello and servus from Bavaria. Welcome to our Mahlo webcast, also known as mCast. In the case that you're here for the very first time, I invite you to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Here we constantly introduce new videos, new movies, where we explain our concept about quality management in the textile production. My name is Stefan Kehry. I'm responsible for the textile applications in Mahlo, and today I want to handle the case of terry towels. Due to the surface of the terry towels, the piles, the weft structure is very hard to identify. However, we need to have a straight product, and we have to have a product which is always having the same length repeat, and therefore we have to identify all the possibilities that we get to straighten and to optimize the length of the terry towels. Let's jump right in how to manage that. What you can expect in the next minutes is, first of all, what matters with the terry towel production, then the line scan camera. This is how we overcome the weft and the warp dimension. Then the benefits which are linked to that new technology. And then, of course, we will give you some application samples as well to have a good introduction into your production. But let's start, first of all, with a small question related to your production. Are there any particular issues that you are facing in your production that you want to share together with us in order to get any assistance, or we can share our experience in this field together with you? That would be very, very great if you could give us something in the comments, and then we can come back to you and help you with those issues individually. Now, what matters? Of course, terry towels with all the piles, we don't get a clear visibility of the weft. And the weft normally is for us the indication about straight fabric or bow and skew fabric, or as well as the repeat. So here we have to look for other things. Those other things are the patterns. In particular, with the terry towels, we have the bars. These bars are clearly visible over here, and they are a very good indicator for any distortion. However, we have to look at those bars not with our normal sensors, which are indicating the weft. Here we have to use a special camera which are looking into those bars. As we know very well, all those steps are happening at a very late stage, where already a lot of value added operations have taken place, and therefore it is very important that at that stage we make sure that everything is really working absolutely 100%, and that we don't have any reject at that stage. Here we can actually discover if we have a skew or bow distortion, and of course we can also measure the repeat. We can correct the distortion with our straighteners, and the repeat can be adjusted by the overfeed of the stentor. As we know very well, the operators not always are big help. In particular, on a Friday afternoon or a Monday morning, the performance of those gentlemen are not always on a constant high quality level, and therefore it's always much better to have an automated closed loop system like the Mahlo to give you not always exactly the right measure to control things, but also to provide the information to make things better in the future. But first, let's check out what we want to measure and how it will look like. No! Rubbish! First of all, let's find out, together with you, gentlemen, whether or not the quality demands of Terry Towel are rising because the people want to have something sustainable, or if they stay on a constant level, or if the quality is dropping in order to save some cost and to make things cheaper in the long term. So if you could also put that down in the comments, I would appreciate it very much. Now, what matters? It's first of all the residual distortion that you can see over here, and on the other side it's also the pattern repeat to make sure that we always have the same length of the different Terry towels. How do we do that? So at the distortion, we first select an area of interest, and as we normally have different areas and different Terry towel sections, we can choose up to 20 in our system, and in those different areas of interest we individually determine a single signal curve where we can see whether it's skew or if it's straight. And this is then summing up to different maximum and different orientations, and therefore we get actually an information about the skew in every single section. And if we summarize that, it gives us a very good indication about how this distortion is happening in the fabric, and this is the information for the weft straightener how to control and repair this distortion in the production. This is how it would look like in the camera system. Here you have a clear picture of the different sections that you have in the production unit. And here you can see the cross sections, which are indicating the skew of the different sections in order to make it actually straight. This is the line scan camera, which is taking all those informations. Line scan camera means that it is handling a continuous movement of the web, Terry towel, and the line scan camera is actually having a very, very fine row of light, 1 millimeter thick, and these scans are scanning the moving objects line by line. This is where the name comes from, and is giving you all those informations by different slices, like you have it in a scanner on the printer. So the encoder on the other side is providing the information about the length, because the encoder is monitoring the speed. The speed is actually also giving you an indication of the length, and is then together with the camera monitoring exactly the size and the dimension of the object, and is providing all the information to the brain, to the computer. And with that computer, we can then give that information to the straightening on the one side and to the roller, the overfeed roller at the stander on the other side, in order to fix the skew, the bow distortion, and also the repeat. Here, once again, the bullet points of the line scan camera. It has an adjustable and maximum line frequency of 52,000 lines per second. So this is a lot of data which is provided over there. It's triggered by the encoder, as I said before, and the typical resolution of 1 millimeter is giving you a very, very clear picture and enough data to really get all the necessary information for a correction of both the weft or the skew and the repeat. The data transfer is happening via gigabit Ethernet. Therefore, we don't require such a short distance between the computer and the camera. We can use longer cables that makes you very free in the location where the computer and the controls are located. It has an improved light sensitivity, again, for the better resolution, and you can adjust or connect up to 4 cameras into that system, which makes sure that you also can cover up a very wide fabric for your application. Of course, every camera needs light. The more light, the better it is. And here we have a very strong LED illumination unit. One illumination unit is always serving for 2 cameras, and the quantity of light is 3 times higher than normal light. And on top of that, it is saving a lot of electricity because the power consumption is lower than with normal light, and the stand time is 50,000 hours. So only very, very little hassle with maintenance, hardly any replacement, because it's got a very high durability and it's got a very long stand time. So no issues with the maintenance whatsoever. The benefits are that we can measure the repeats and the patterns with that camera technology. In relation with a straightener, we can correct the skew and the bow, and we can also, by means of the overfeed roller, correct the repeat. Then we have an uninterrupted monitoring and logging of the product quality, which is very important for your final customer, because you can tell him every time, see, this is the quality that has been achieved by us, and there's no way that you can actually hand in a claim or even a reject. We have the transparency to make things better in our production and to improve things. Life is about improving constantly. Then you have the latest camera technology. At the moment, there is no better choice than the latest line scan camera that we have in our portfolio, and it gives us the opportunity, due to the modular assembly, to fit it into your production as soon as possible. Here are some nice application examples. So it is important to have the fabric opened, dewatered, and guided through the tumble dryer. Then the weft straightening is prior to the tendering field over here, because there it is the final step where we can control things, where we can improve things, where we can repair things. The illumination on both sides of the fabric, that means we can either use the transmission mode or the reflection mode. Both is possible and gives you a lot of opportunities to get the best picture from your fabric. So if you have wider width, more than 2.4 meters, we often use 2 cameras, which again is giving you a better picture, and this is what matters in this concern. The cameras installed at the exit are monitoring the final quality. Why? Simply because you want to give, like insurance, some data to your customers that is showing the good quality which is coming out of your production. And automatic control of the speed is also possible with those cameras, because they give you a clear indication about the repeat at that stage as well. So the advantages that you have with the PCS camera in a glance is that you always have a very high and constant quality which is coming out of your production. And even without the clear weft visibility, you always have a right first time. You don't have claims, you don't have rejects. The monitoring and logging is leading to a much better relationship to your customers and makes sure that you always have a good transparency about what is happening to you. Good transparency is always a very good basis for better understanding and a very good relationship also in the long term. So the latest camera technology that we provide is making sure that even in 5, in 10, in 20 years, you are still on a very high level of technology, and it gives you the knowledge that you're always one step ahead of your competitors. Finally, the modular assembly enables you to really get that latest technology within the next weeks or month, and you can make sure that you start improving things in your production as soon as possible. So that has been a short insight about the pattern control system in relation with our TerriTowels. And if you liked the content, then you can also look into our YouTube channel. You can subscribe to our YouTube channel, then we will send the new videos to you. We have a video section on our website as well. Of course, it goes without saying, if you want to have the presentation, drop me an email. It's stefan.kirchi@mahlo.com. And once you are in the comment sections, I would be very, very grateful if I get a thumbs up. So thank you once again for your time, and I hope that I could actually give you something for your TerriTowel production. See you again soon. Bye-bye.